Hello everyone, I Neha Patil welcome you all in today's session. In today's session, now we'll see one type of a queue, that is the circular queue. Already we have seen introduction about the linear queue, operations on the linear queue, limitations of the linear queue. And now in this video, we'll see the information about the circular queue. So circular queue is nothing but it is a variant of the linear queue, which effectively overcomes the limitations of the linear queue. In circular queue, the new element is added at the very first position of the queue if the last is occupied and space is available. Actually, this is one of the advantages of the circular queue, or we can say to overcome the drawback of the linear queue, we are implementing the circular queue. In array implementation of the circular queue, we have seen it is similar to the implementation of the queue. The only difference is that as soon as the rear index of the queue reaches the maximum size of the array, rear is reset to the beginning of the queue, but the condition is what? The space should be the free in the first. The circular queue is full only when all the locations in the array are occupied. Here, this is the diagram related with the circular queue. So what we can say here, the drawback of the linear queue is nothing but what? If some spaces in the front side are empty, but if our rear is at the last position, then we can't use that free spaces for the new insertion there. So for that purpose, we have, so this is the second type of the queue, that is the circular queue, where that rear end we can reset to the zero and we can do the new insertions there. So this is actually the importance or the advantage of the circular queue over the linear queue. So see here, I have shown here the various states after insertion and the deletion of some elements into the circular queue. So initially, only one element is present in the queue. That's why the front and rear both are at the same position. So this is the case where the circular queue with one element. Now in the second case, I have inserted few elements into the queue. So front is again at the zeroth position, but the rear is at the fourth position here. Then after deleting first two elements here, the queue will look like this. The front end is at the second position and rear end is at the third position here. Now, after again doing some insertions here, now if you are able to see here, the rear is at the last position, that is the max minus one here, but the front is at the second position here. And these two spaces, that is the zeroth index and the first index, is actually empty here. So now here, after this, if I want to do the new insertion, then this rear, now we can set to the zero here, like here, in this case E here. I have inserted the one more element into the queue. So your rear is at now the zeroth position here. And your front is at the third position here. As these spaces were empty, so we have used that spaces here. Now after doing again the two more insertions here, the queue will fill like this way here. That is 5, 6, 7, 40, 50, 60. These are the elements present into the queue and the queue is full. But if you are able to see here, now, whenever the queue is full here, the rear is not at the last position here. It is in the somewhere middle position there. And here, the front is not at the zeroth position. It is actually one position behind the rear here. So this is the only condition whenever the circular queue is going to become the full here. When all the elements are occupied here, then only your circular queue is going to become the full here. Otherwise, it is not going to become the full here. So this condition we have to remember at the time of the implementation. Now, we'll see here two formulas actually to how to calculate the number of elements in the circular queue here. So the first case is what? Whenever your front is less than the rear here, then the total number of elements present into the queue, we can calculate with the help of this formula, rear minus front plus one. The rear index minus your front index plus one. If we are going to do this, we will get the total number of elements present into the circular queue when the front is less than the rear. Now in the second case here, when the front is greater than the rear here, then the same formula, the total number of elements is equal to max plus rear minus front plus 1 here. So the max is nothing but what? The size of the queue here. Max plus rear minus front plus 1 here. So this is the formula whenever the front is greater than rear and if we want to calculate the total number of elements present into the circular queue. So these two formulas you have to always remember, because based on this in your online examination, they can frame the question here. Now, this is the insertion algorithm or the code we can see here. So while inserting, again, we are testing here the condition. If the front and rear both are at the minus one, that means if the initially the queue is empty, the front is equal to rear is equal to zero and queue of rear is equal to x, that means in that rear position, we are going to insert the element here. Else here, if front is equal to equal to rear plus 1 mod size here, then what we are going to do here, we are going to check the queue full condition. This is the only condition when the queue is going to become the full here. Actually, another condition is also there. If the front is at the zeroth position and the rear is at the last position, then also the circular queue can become the full here. Otherwise, if the front is one position less than the rear, then the circular queue will be the full here. And if the queue is not full and not empty, then just we have to increment here the rear. That is, the rear is equal to rear plus 1 mod size here. Q of rear is equal to x here. So rear is equal to rear plus 1 mod size. This modular incrementation is very important here. Why? Because whenever we are going to do the normal incrementation like rear is equal to rear plus 1, then if the rear is at the fifth index, it will become like the sixth. But now what I want here, whenever the rear is at the last position, I want to reset it to the zero here. That's why here, instead of the normal incrementation, always in case of the circular queue, in insertion also and in the deletion also, both the front and the rear, we have to increment, and that is nothing but the modular incrementation we have to do here. That is, the rear is equal to rear plus 1 mod size here. Size is nothing but the whatever be the array size is there. So this always we have to remember here in case of the circular queue. Instead of the normal incrementation, we are going to take the modular incrementation. Now, this is the deletion code here. Again, at the time of the deletion, if the queue is, that means if the front is equal to minus 1, we can say like the queue is empty here. And here, otherwise, P is equal to Q of front. That means whatever the element present at the front end that we are going to take out in the P variable, we are going to display it. And then that front end, we are going to increment to point to the next element there. But again, here, if you are able to see here, the front is equal to front plus 1 mod size we have taken here. That means, again, modular incrementation we have taken here instead of the front is equal to front plus plus here. So this always you have to remember here, that always in case of the insertion also and in case of the deletion also of the circular queue, instead of the normal incrementation, we have to take here the modular incrementation. So conclusion is nothing but what? These are actually the advantages of the circular queue over the linear queue. Easy insertion and the deletion. In linear queue, insertion is not possible once the rear reaches the last index, even if there are the empty spaces present into the queue. But in circular queue, elements can be inserted easily if there are the vacant spaces until it is not fully occupied. So this is the first advantage. Second is what? Efficient memory utilization. The same thing in the circular queue, no wastage of memory as it uses the unoccupied spaces also. Then ease of operations in the linear queue, FIFO is followed. That is, the element inserted first is the element to be deleted first. But in case of the circular queue, as the rear and front are not fixed here, so the order of the insertion and deletion can be changed here. So these are the few advantages of the circular queue over the linear queue. So this will help you at the time of the giving difference between the linear queue and the circular queue here. So hope you understood the difference between the linear queue and the circular queue and operations on the circular queue. So thank you very much for watching this video.